Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to AstroEdify. Today we are going to talk about our next nakshatra, which is Swati Nakshatra. So far we have discussed till Chitra Nakshatra. So today we are going to talk about Swati Nakshatra, and we will discuss that what is Swati Nakshatra and what are the various qualities that this nakshatra infuses into its natives. So let's discuss about that. And the people who want to view this whole video in Hindi can check out the link shown below, and they will be able to watch this whole video in Hindi as well. So let's move on. And if you don't know that what is a nakshatra and what how the categorization or classification is being done in Vedic astrology, and of planets, of rashis, and of that is of zodiac signs, and how the classification is being done of degrees, and of various nakshatras, that how many nakshatras are there in between a single spread of 30 degree, and how many pad are there in one nakshatra, and how they are classified, what zodiac sign do they represent, and how the Naumansha or D9 is being constructed based upon the pad, and what are gun, what is what are elements. If you don't know about these things, then check out my Ashwini Nakshatra video. In that video I have told each and everything in detail, so that each and every person can understand these basic concepts before jumping into the detail of a particular nakshatra. So let's move on and discuss that what is Swati Nakshatra. Actually, Swati Nakshatra, the ruler of Swati Nakshatra is Rahu, and according to the ruler, the as the planet which rules a particular nakshatra also has some qualities which it induces into the nakshatra which it is ruling. So Swati Nakshatra has some traits of Rahu as well. So this nakshatra is spread from 6 degree 41 minutes to 20 degrees Libra. That means this nakshatra is totally spread in Libra zodiac sign. Each zodiac sign is of 30 degree long, and in that particular 30 degrees it is spread from 6 degrees 41 minutes to 20 degrees Libra. Then let's talk about its symbol. Its symbol is a young plant shoot, a small plant which is in the process of growth. So a young plant shoot which is blown away by the wind, it is its symbol. And according to the symbol, the qualities are being judged or represented by a nakshatra. So this plant shoot, at it as it is being blown by the wind, shows all the airy qualities like restlessness or adaptability, roaming disposition, dexterity. This nakshatra governs all these qualities, it represents all these qualities. So the people who are the natives of Swati Nakshatra have these qualities in them. They are very adaptable to nature, and as Swati Nakshatra is a very smooth nakshatra. It represents a part in a life which is very smooth. So it represents all the things which are not coming with the help of a struggle, or not showing too much struggle. So it represents a smoothness in life. So these people are very adaptable. They are fickle because they have roaming disposition. So they have dilemmas, continuous dilemmas in their mind, that they should do this or not do this. They are intelligent because they are very good learners, and they are very restless also sometimes. So these are the various things this nakshatra represents. And the next thing is, what are its traits, what are its characteristics that this nakshatra infuses into its natives. By natives I mean that the people who are having their moon placed in Swati Nakshatra in their horoscope. No other planet we are talking about here, we are talking about the moon placement in Swati Nakshatra. So what happens when your moon is placed in Swati Nakshatra, what qualities will you be having in yourself? So we'll talk about that. So Swati Nakshatra is all about balance. Why balance? Because it is totally spread in between in Libra zodiac sign, and the symbol for Libra is a balance. So it represents all the things. These people want balance in their life continuously. They don't want any sort of as this nakshatra is about smoothness, so they don't want any kind of harsh things or any kind of difficulties in their life. So they want their life to be smooth and balanced. So balance is the key word for this nakshatra. Then these people are they have very inconclusive thinking. So they don't know that they are not coming to a particular decision quickly. So they have dilemmas in their mind continuously. Then the next thing is that these people are open to new thoughts, and they listen to other people. So they are very good learners. Then the next thing is that these people are have extreme procrastination, that they have a habit that they put the today's work on the next day. They plan all the thing, but they will put that work or load onto the next day, that I will do it tomorrow, and then tomorrow they will say I will do it tomorrow. So this is a habit in the natives of Swati Nakshatra, because they have extreme procrastination. Then if we go by appearance, these people are very slim, elegant, and they have a smiley face always. And these people are long-term planners, because in this nakshatra, Saturn is exalted. Again, in nakshatras also, certain planets are exalted and debilitated. So Saturn is exalted here. So as Saturn is the ruler for long-term things, so these people are long-term planners. And this nakshatra is falling in Venus, falling in Libra, which is ruled by Venus, and its ruler is Rahu. So these both planets make this nakshatra very make these natives very diplomatic, and they get easily recognized in the society. Most of the Swati natives get easily recognized in the society based upon their talents and skills. And the next thing is that this nakshatra makes a person very business minded and very business oriented person, and person do very well if he is associated with business or business or legal partnerships. Then he performs very well in his profession, and this nakshatra makes a person very rich, very very rich, because this nakshatra there are three things which form integral part of this nakshatra. The three things are: first is law, the second is money, and the third is extreme sexual desire. So these are the three things which form the integral part of this nakshatra. And based upon these things, based upon the planetary placement, here we are talking about moon, but based upon other planetary placements also, you can see that whether this nakshatra is having a positive energy or a negative energy, in the sense that a person will be abiding the law, or a person will be breaking the law and making his own rules to gain money and to gain recognition, to fulfill his all sorts of wishes and desires. Then this nakshatra, as I told, this nakshatra makes person very business minded. So people who are having this nakshatra, or the natives of this nakshatra, should do business, because they will perform very good in this field. And these people are very courteous and very civilized. They will, because in business you need both of these things, because without a good tongue, you cannot, without a proper speech, you cannot move ahead in business field. So these people are very polite, very civilized, very well mannered, and very courteous. They attract people by their speech. So these are the various things that this nakshatra represents, and these are the various qualities that this nakshatra infuses into its natives. So we have discussed that what are the various qualities that a native of a Swati Nakshatra possess. Now we talk about what is this nakshatra. The gender of this nakshatra is first of all female, and the gun of this nakshatra is tamasic. There are three gun, sattvic, rajasic and tamasic. If you don't know what gun are, check on my Ashwini Nakshatra video. And the next thing is its element is fire element. There are four elements: fire, earth, air and water. So it belongs to the fire element. And let's talk about its pad. There are four pad in each and every nakshatra. So this is the last subdivision which is being done in Vedic astrology. So there are four pad in every nakshatra, and each and every pad determines which planet will be sitting in which zodiac sign in your D9 chart, that is Naumansha chart. So based upon the pad, the Naumansha chart or D9 chart is being constructed. And how it is being constructed, so let's see. If you are any planet, here we have talked about the qualities which we have talked about are totally based on moon, moon placement in Swati Nakshatra. But what I am going to tell you about now, pad, so this can be any planet. So if your any planet is being placed in Swati Nakshatra and Swati Nakshatra is placed in pad 1, then your planet which is sitting in Swati Nakshatra will occupy the Sagittarius zodiac sign in your D9 chart. In your Naumansha chart, it will sit in Sagittarius sign. Then if it is nakshatra is sitting in pad 2, then that planet will sit in the sign of Capricorn in your D9 chart. If this nakshatra is sitting in pad 3, then the planet which is occupying which is sitting in Swati Nakshatra will sit in the zodiac sign of Aquarius in your D9 chart or Naumansha chart. And similarly, if it is this nakshatra is placed in pad 4, then that planet will sit in the Pisces zodiac sign of Pisces zodiac sign in your D9 chart or Naumansha chart. So these are the various things we have discussed about Swati Nakshatra. We have discussed what who is its ruler and what is its symbol, what are the various qualities of this nakshatra and what are the various qualities of Swati natives, and what type of nakshatra is this, and we have talked about its pad and how the planets are being placed in D9 chart based upon the pad placement. So if you are new to my channel, just subscribe below by clicking the subscribe button. And if you have any queries regarding yourself or any astrological concept, you can mail me on my email ID shown in the description. For more information, check on my Facebook page, and we will meet in the next video. So of next nakshatra. So till then, goodbye and thank you.